Hello everybody, my name is Christina. Today I'm going to present our work entitled Nano-enabled multilayer coatings with switchable bacterial killing activities for prevention of catheter-related infections. So first, I would like to say some facts about bacterial infections and the development of antimicrobial resistance. So antimicrobial resistant infections are the greatest challenges of the 21st century, being responsible for 700,000 deaths annually and expected to reach almost 10 million deaths and 1,000 trillion financial loss by 2050. More than 490,000 new antimicrobial resistant bacteria appear every year, and up to 3 million people per year acquire antimicrobial resistant infections during their stay in a hospital. So another concern is that only 30% of the developing countries have plans against antimicrobial resistant development. So the question is how bacteria resist the antibiotic actions. So within the use of antibiotics, bacteria develop very sophisticated mechanisms to survive the antibiotics therapies. So they produce different enzymes to alter or degrade the antibiotic, or express efflux pumps to transport out of the cells the drug. This is what we call individual resistance of free-floating bacterial cells. What is more concerning is the so-called collective resistance, when bacteria form biofilms, which are a complex community of cells protected from the hostile environment by self-produced extracellular polymeric matrix. So these biofilms are 100 times more resistant to drugs than the free-floating bacterial cells. So antibiotic-resistant biofilms may be formed on living surfaces, including lungs, wounds, teeth, causing difficult-to-treat infections, or they may form on non-living surfaces as implants and indwelling medical devices, for example, catheters. Actually, more than 40% of all hospital-acquired infections are catheter-related, and 80% of all infections on the urinary tract are due to catheterization. So, current strategies as frequent replacement of the device and aggressive antibiotic therapies are only a short-term solution associated with side effects as hypersensitivity, inflammation, and so on. And in this work, actually, we aimed to develop innovative solution to inhibit bacterial growth and biofilm formation on catheter surfaces. So our approach consists of engineering cell defensive coatings of nanoparticles, which have shown enhanced antibacterial activity than the free counterparts due to the better interaction with bacterial membrane and easy access to the target site. The combination of these nanoparticles with chloroquenching enzymes such as acylase, which are able to disrupt bacterial cell-to-cell communication and prevent the biofilm formation on the surfaces, is expected to demonstrate even higher antimicrobial efficacy than the individual approaches. So the main advantage of this combined strategy containing nanoparticles and quorum-quenching enzymes has several advantages, avoids the time and resource consuming for screening for new antimicrobials. There is a low risk of resistance development due to the different mechanism of antimicrobial actions, mainly membrane disruptions and disruption and quorum sensing inhibition. So at the beginning, we developed hybrid silver lignin nanoparticles using lignin as both reducing and capping agent. So the developed nanoparticle had high colloidal stability. Their zeta potential was above 30. They also presented small size, which is around 50 nanometers, even lower, and low polydispersity index. Importantly, silver-linear nanoparticles were very efficient against a panel of susceptible and multi-drug resistant pathogens, which were isolated from clinical hospital environment. And this effect actually was not seen for the stand-alone silver nanoparticles, which clearly demonstrate that the developed silver-linear nanoparticles possess a great potential to find multi-drug resistant bacterium. So on the next slide, you can see how these nanoparticles interact with different bacterial strains. We tested their ability to inhibit their interaction with Pseudomonas aeruginosa, Klebsiella pneumoniae, Acinetobacter baumannii, and Staphylococcus aureus. So on the images, upon the interaction of the nanoparticles, the cells demonstrated cellular damage, including disruption of the cell membrane integration and loss of cytoplasmic content. Moreover, some of the nanoparticles were found in the cytoplasmic space, which indicates the ability of those nanoparticles to penetrate the membrane and affect essential life-supporting metabolic processes in bacteria. So these antibacterial nanoparticles were further assembled with antibiofilm anti-infective chloro-quenching acylase and bacteria-degradable elastin in stable nano-enabled catheter coatings for triggered killing of Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Different number of oppositely charged layers were assembled, all silicon catheters in a layer-by-layer fashion, and their antibacterial activity was further assessed. So what we found is that increasing the number of layers and consequently the amount of nanoparticles in the coating does not improve the killing effect when of our materials when they're exposed to Pseudomonas aeruginosa, which is a common pathogen found in catheter-associated urinary tract infections. So this hybrid silver-linear nano-enabled coatings developed after 10 sequential deposition step of 4.5 bilayers, as here, as demonstrated here, reduced the growth by of bacteria by more than 3 logs, and therefore were subjected to further analysis. The selected hybrid coatings actually were able to inhibit the Pseudomonas aeruginosa biofilm growth, as was confirmed after live biofilm cells counting and microscopic visualization of the biofilm after staining with live dead kit, cells viability kit. So all the which the results were better for the hybrid coatings when compared to the individual coatings. A part of that, the multilayers were 100% biocompatible to skin fibroblasts and keratinocytes. All the cells that were exposed to the coatings or were placed in a contact with those coatings for up to 7 days were live. This was confirmed by the Alamar Blue assay and did not present any changes in their morphology in comparison to the pristine silicone. So finally, to summarize the most important outcomes of our work, the work was supported and the hybrid silver-linear nanoparticles obtained by environmentally friendly reduction of silver ions to metallic silver with lignin demonstrated strong antibacterial activity against susceptible and multi-drug resistant bacteria. Hybrid silver lignin nanoparticles and quorum quenching enzyme acylase were sequentially assembled with bacteria degradable elastin, producing multilayers with switchable killing activities. The hybrid multilayers were able to completely inhibit the planktonic growth and biofilm formation of Pseudomonas aeruginosa. The developed coatings demonstrated excellent biocompatibility. So this work was supported by the European project PROTEIT and the national Spanish project called TOSAVE. Thank you for your attention.